Welcome to the training, Submit a Feed Using SPAPI. This video is designed for developers with fully integrated Selling Partner API applications. Developers can use the Selling Partner API for Feeds or Feeds API to build out an application so sellers can upload data to Amazon and perform actions in bulk. Feeds and bulk actions allow sellers to streamline various selling activities, including listing, managing inventory and prices, and fulfilling orders. We also offer feeds for fulfillment by Amazon or FBA, Amazon Business, and EasyShip. All feeds available through SPAPI are designed for seller applications. They're not intended for use with vendors. In what follows, we review the process for submitting a feed and provide sample Java code you can use to model submissions in Java and other programming languages. You can also use the samples in this video to model submissions that use other HTTP client libraries or to upload feeds in different formats. After reviewing step-by-step instructions for submitting a feed, we troubleshoot common issues. You can find written instructions for submitting and troubleshooting a feed by visiting the SPAPI documentation website. Scroll down the table of contents to the Feeds API header. Then select the reference page with the most recent date in the past and click the Use Case Guide with the same date. Any earlier versions are outdated, and versions dated in the future haven't been released yet. Let's start by reviewing a few requirements for submitting a feed to Amazon. Before you begin the process, you'll need to identify a relevant feed type. For a complete list, select the Feed Type Values page from the table of contents on the SPAPI documentation website. Then select a feed according to the needs of your seller. Your application will require authorization from your seller before you can submit a feed. If you need more information about the authorization process, refer to the relevant Step 2 video in our series Integrate with SPAPI. After you've fulfilled the requirements for submitting a feed, you're ready to start the submission process. It involves a few basic steps. You'll start by constructing your feed and obtaining a destination URL for the upload. Then you'll perform the upload and submit your feed to Amazon. After you've submitted, you'll confirm that your feed has completed processing. Then you'll get a URL to download your feed processing report and check the report for errors. Let's review each of these steps in depth. First, you'll construct the feed you want to upload. You can use an XML file to upload limited data or a flat file to upload data in bulk. Make sure you wrap an XML feed in an envelope XSD. For more information about XML feeds and an example feed, select Step 2, Construct a Feed, from the table of contents in the Feeds API Use Case Guide. After constructing your feed, you'll move to the second step in the submission process and obtain a destination URL. To do so, call the Create Feed Document operation, passing the content type parameter. We recommend UTF-8 character encoding for content type. Here's an example request. This operation will return a pre-signed URL, which you'll use to upload the contents of your feed document. You'll need to upload within 5 minutes before the URL expires. The Create Feed Document operation will also return a feed document ID, which you'll use to create a feed. You'll need to complete this later step within 2 days before the ID expires. Here's an example response. When you have your destination URL, you'll upload your feed to it as the third step in the submission process. Your specific upload code will depend on your chosen programming language or HTTP client library. The following sample Java code demonstrates one way you might upload feed content. In this example, the upload method accepts feed content as the first argument and the URL values as the second. You can take a longer look at this example code by selecting Step 3, Upload the Feed Data from the Table of Contents in the Feeds API Use Case Guide. With your feed uploaded, you'll then submit it to Amazon as the fourth step in the process. To do so, call the Create Feed operation, passing the parameters feed type, marketplace IDs, input feed document ID, and feed options. Feed type is your chosen feed value, which you selected from the Feed Type Values page. Marketplace IDs is the full list of IDs for the marketplaces you want the feed applied to. For a list of marketplace IDs, select marketplace IDs from the table of contents on the SPAPI documentation website. Input feed document ID is the identifier returned when you called the Create Feed Document operation in the first step of the submission process. As a reminder, this ID expires after 2 days. Finally, Feed Options is used for additional feed control options. These will vary by feed type. Here's an example request with the Feed Options parameter. And here's an example request without the Feed Options parameter. A successful response to the Create Feed operation will include the element Feed ID. This is the identifier for your feed. Note that this ID is unique only in combination with the ID of the seller for whom you're submitting the feed. Here's an example response. After submitting your feed to Amazon, you'll continue with steps related to feed processing. First, you'll confirm your feed has processed by calling the Get Feed operation, passing the feed ID parameter you just received. Here's an example request. A successful response will include the elements Feed ID, Feed Type, Marketplace IDs, Created Time, Processing Status, Processing End Time, Result Feed Document ID, and Processing Start Time. Created time is the date and time the feed was generated in ISO 8601 format. Processing start and end time are the dates and times your feed began and ended. Result feed document ID is the identifier for the feed document and is unique only in combination with the ID of the seller for whom you are submitting the feed. Finally, processing status is the current status of your feed. This will be in queue, in progress, canceled, fatal, or done. Here's an example response. You'll want to call the Get Feed operation periodically until the element processing status returns as done. To reduce the number of calls you make, we recommend using the Notifications API to subscribe to the event Feed Processing Finished. This event notifies you when the processing status of a feed changes. For more information, visit the SPAPI documentation website and select the Notifications API Use Case Guide from the table of contents. A processing status of done indicates that your feed has processed completely and that you're ready to move to the next step in the submission process. You can call the Get Feed operation for up to 90 days after a request has been created. If processing status returns as in queue or in progress, your feed is still processing. Wait a little longer, then call the Get Feed operation again. If processing status returns as canceled, your feed was terminated before processing began. Start again with step one of the feed submission process and obtain a destination URL. If processing status returns as fatal, your feed encountered an error while processing and was terminated. Some or all of the operations within the feed might have been completed successfully. Move to the next step in the submission process. You'll need to complete the process in full to determine how the error has impacted your feed. After your feed has processed, you'll request a pre-signed URL to download the feed processing report. This report will indicate which records were submitted successfully and which generated errors. To request the pre-signed URL, call the Get Feed Document operation, passing the Feed Document ID parameter. This is the identifier for your feed document and should be the result feed document ID value that was returned in the previous step. Here's an example request. A successful response will include the elements Feed Document ID and URL, and it might include the element Compression Algorithm. As a reminder, the URL for the feed document expires after 5 minutes. The compression algorithm, if present, will compress the feed content as indicated. Here's an example response. As the next step in the process, you'll use the pre-signed URL you just received to download the feed processing report. The following example Java code demonstrates one way you might accomplish a download. It can be used to model downloads in Java and other programming languages. In this example, the URL is the argument for URL, and the optional compression algorithm values are parameters of the download method of the download example class. You can take a longer look at the sample code by selecting Step 7, Download the Feed Processing Report from the table of contents in the Feed's API Use Case Guide. Before you download your first processing report, it's important to note that it's the developer's responsibility to maintain encryption at rest. Unencrypted feed processing report content should never be stored on disk, even temporarily, because it can contain sensitive information. Finally, as the last step in the feed submission process, you'll check for errors in the feed processing report you downloaded. If you find no errors after receiving done as your feed's processing status, your feed submission is complete. You've successfully finished the process. If you find no errors after receiving fatal as your feed's processing status, you'll want to resubmit it. Your submission might have been terminated during processing for reasons unrelated to the feed. You should start the submission process again to ensure your feed is completely processed without errors and returns done as a processing status. The report you receive with a fatal status might be in a different format than that of a successfully completed feed. If you find one or more errors in your feed processing report after receiving either done or fatal as your processing status, you'll want to correct those errors, then resubmit. Repeat the process until you receive done as your processing status and your report is error-free. Finally, if you don't receive a processing report after getting fatal as your processing status, you should resubmit the feed to try to get one. Now that you're familiar with the process for submitting a feed, let's troubleshoot some common issues. Developers sometimes encounter error code 403, unauthorized access denied, while submitting a feed. Try these tips to resolve it. Tip 1, have the seller whose account you're making the request to confirm that their account has a healthy status. They can check their Seller Central homepage for an alert or select Performance, then Account Health from the menu to review their full account status. If a seller's account isn't healthy, they aren't able to use SPAPI, but they can improve their status to gain access. Tip 2, confirm that your application is still authorized by the seller. As a reminder, you can review the authorization process using the Step 2 videos in our Integrate with SPAPI series. Tip 3, double-check that the necessary roles are attached to your application. Roles group and grant access to various operations, including those used for feeds. For more information about roles, refer to our video, Intro to SPAPI Roles. In addition to these 3 tips, you should follow a few basic guidelines to help reduce errors. Submit larger combined feeds rather than multiple feeds with limited records. Allow more time between larger feeds. Keep file sizes below 10 MB. Upload a feed of the same type no more than once every 20 minutes. If you're submitting a listings feed, include only the products being updated, not a seller's entire inventory. Finally, be sure you don't rely on the format and structure of document identifiers, as they are subject to change. This concludes our training on submitting a feed using SPAPI. As a reminder, you can search for the Feeds API Use Case Guide in the table of contents on the SPAPI documentation website if you'd like to learn more or take a longer look at the example code in this video. Make sure you select the version of the Use Case Guide with the most recent date in the past. Thanks for watching.